Alice is facing the issue that her simple algorithm, while it's correct, does not show an acceptable running time. So we should probably say a little bit more as to what we would consider an acceptable running time, like here, and what we would consider an unacceptable running time. And in theoretical computer science, or at least for the first units of this course, we're just making a distinction between two cases, basically. The first case here is polynomial running time. And polynomial running time means that the algorithm has a running time that can be stated as some polynomial of the size of the input. So polynomial time would be an algorithm that has a running time of O of n, O of n squared. But even an algorithm with a running time such as O of n to the power of 10, or worse, would be considered a polynomial time algorithm. And we would say that the running time of this algorithm is more or less acceptable. Now, exponential running time, those are the algorithms that have n in the exponent of their running time. So O of 2 to the power of n would be an algorithm with exponential running time. O of 1.1 to the power of n would be an algorithm with exponential running time. And also something really bad, such as O of 10 to the power of n, that would also be an exponential running time. What about an algorithm such as O of 3 to the power of n times n to the power of 2? That would also be called exponential running time, because as you saw in previous quizzes, the 3 to the power of n is the fastest growing term here. So the dominant term here is an exponential term. So running times like this would also fall under exponential running time.